Congratulations again on this extraordinary character. But I wanted to ask you about how important it is for you for the character and the film to have a message, but a message that's kind of learned through experience and time, really, in terms of the way the characters learn about their kind of journeys.
Yes, I think, and I think we all have very complex characters, which is really nice and not often the case in an ensemble, and the way we balance each other, learn from each other, and change over the years for some of us. And for Maleficent, yes, I loved the first one where we went back and said, well, we think of her as evil and dark, and first movie we asked why and went deeper in, and I think most women, most people, aren't born with a certain hardness and aggression. Something happens along your life where you lose trust, you don't feel safe, and you start to fight in a different way, and you protect yourself in a different way. And then through having a child, she finds her softness again. But then there was a question in this of, well, she's not just soft and trying to be small and cover her horns and adjust. She is a fighter, and she is a creature, and she is all these other things, and is she allowed to be both? And can she find herself or just keep apologizing for that thing within her and stay small? And so she's on her own journey to find out what that means. So I think it has beautiful messages about finding your true self and being it, embracing others. And also one of my favorite themes is that family is not made of blood.
Yeah.
This film talks about evil and good, and in a way with what things are happening in the world right now, in the real world. Can this film or this story, can it give us some inspiration how to fight evil?
Well, I think it helps to maybe identify where some of the darkness is coming from and what is the true darkness. And really in this film, the mistress of evil is less Maleficent and more Queen Ingrid, who is someone who... I'm going to have a soundtrack during this answer. It's okay. Queen Ingrid is... when you see a leader like her who is so angry and so hostile and so much believes that the only way to survive is to destroy the other... We make it very clear in this film that she is afraid, she is weak, and she is ignorant. And that is why she is behaving that way, and that is why she is wrong. And that is why the leaders that need to take place, which would be Aurora's character in the future, are those who see the strength and diversity, appreciate environment, respect for each other, respect for themselves, and are more forward-thinking and have a different vision. So these are themes that many children, many people may see and may not really. It's not political. It's not trying to be. But I do think if in the end you're happy about the way the film ends and it feels right, I think that heads you in the right direction. I think for children, it gives a nice guide.
Thank you.
As a new mother, my baby is 3.5 months.
Congratulations.
Thank you. She's called Jemima. I love how Disney is constantly reinventing itself and creating role models for young girls. How do you think Maleficent tackles this?
Being role models in the film? Well, I think it's a few things. I think it's not, one, it's not just girls in the film, because we have strong women. We also have the character that is wrong in the film and has to be taken out is also a woman. But we show very diverse types of women between our characters. But also we have extraordinary men in the film, and I really want to press that point, because I think that so often when a story is told to say this is a strong woman, she has to beat the man, or she has to be like the man, or she has to somehow not need the man. And we both very much need and love and learn from the men. And so I think that that's also an important message for young girls, to find their own power, but to respect and learn from the men around them.
Thank you.
question is also for Miss Jolie. What was it like working with Joachim Rønning, and why did you want to work with him in the first place? Had you seen Kon-Tiki, for instance?
Disney was very excited about Joachim. And I think it was a really, it's always interesting to work with different directors and have a new take on a film, since our first director made a beautiful film, and then deceived new fresh eyes.
First of all, I wanted to say that I think you're all great. And my question is for Angelina. She is my favourite actress. I mean, one of them. And also, I do love Elle Fanning as well, and all of you. just wanted to make that clear.
Keep going.
But you've achieved so much in your life. And do you have any goals left for your future? I'm just wondering.
It's like the pressure. That
wow, yeah.
It's kind of like... I have a lot. I do. I feel... I love being an artist. I'm not sure that's there are many other things I'd like the other aspects of my work to take over my life a little bit more. So in the years ahead, and really I just want to raise my children well. They're all at those very special ages where you want to not miss a moment and do your best to get it right before they're out in the world on their own and having to face everything. And you know, you hope you get all the good stuff in. So that's my main focus. But I have some other crazy ideas for future things. We'll see what happens.
Anyway. Please run for president.
I think we'd all like that. Please.
Do you think that there is anywhere for this story to go in the future, even if it's just for your individual characters, how you imagine they would continue on? That's for all of you.
Three very wry smiles going across those.
Sam looks like he's
well, it's some very unusual conversations. Yeah. Some very Disney, some not so Disney.
Yeah, exactly. Where would you like it to go?
Somehow we have to get Chiwetel back. It's a magic. You can come back.
That's easy.
I think we have had lots of ideas. Well, we'd like to be grandparents.
Yeah. No pressure, guys.
You're saying I might be with the Dark Fae then.
If anything happened to, yeah, there may be there was. Oh, okay.
Wow.
Sorry, you had to hear that. Fine. Now. So early on.
It's a public.
We spoke about different things during the film, so
it's like Jerry Springer.
Like Ed's not even speaking about that. He's not even going to keep you quiet. One of the things that's interesting is, without realizing it, we've hit the chapters of the growth of a woman, right? We've hit her from her birth and her christening, to her being a little girl, being a teenage girl, to now being a wife. And so, in a way, the chapters are following a few things, but one of them is how a woman grows and evolves. And so soon, it does make sense that now there's this chapter for Aurora as wife, mother, queen. And what is that? And then, what? And now we've met and the Dark Fae are in. So what is the future for the Dark Fae? And do they return? And personally, I like the idea of getting out of England in the story, like basing England, but going into the world, because we have such a diverse, the Dark Fae represent the world. And so I would love to see them in the world and across the world. God knows what they're doing.
She says, I'm back. Location.
Location. Location. Location.
The way that you so kind of beautifully and delicately land. I mean, the way that just the presence and that kind of... Does it take a lot of practice to... With the kind of... The rope work, I don't even know if that's what it's called, but
yeah, they don't all look that pretty.
Elegantly, you kind of
they pick the nice ones.
it must take a lot of practice though, to it's a mechanical part of the character,
it
really
does. But it takes a second. Well, the guys know now. I mean, the wire work, it was actually fun for me because usually I'm the only one with horns flying. And then to watch everybody else and think, watch, you're about to break your horn off. And then it is, you get in the wire work and your horns are hitting. It's such a, there's so many different
funny things to think about. You nearly impaled me once flying.
Yeah. It's all in the glutes. It's all in the bum, you know. If you tense your bum and your core, then you're strong up there. And, you know, I'm not sure you guys expected to be talking about bums in this conference. Sorry to take it there. But, it was great fun. It was amazing.
Feels like the perfect place to end it, talking about bums, shall we?